Hey folks, today I'm going to show you how you can fix a steering wheel that shakes when you apply your brakes. Alright, so if your steering wheel shakes when you apply your brakes, it is due to having warped front brake rotors. And that basically means the thickness on your brake rotors are different from one place to another. Now this can happen due to rust and corrosion on your brake rotors, or uneven wear on the brake pads due to poor quality brake pads, or a problem with your brake caliper, or in a lot of cases, this sliding pin here losing lubrication, therefore not allowing this brake caliper to move back and forth easily. Now I should mention that if you have vibration issues at highway speeds, like 60 to 75 miles per hour, let's say, and it happens all the time, regardless whether you're applying your brakes or not, then that's usually due to an issue with balance, either balance with the tires, your drive shafts, or something along that line. Now there's a different diagnostic procedure for that, and I have a video on how you can exactly narrow down your problem. I'll put a link to it right here on this side of the screen. I'll put a link to it in the description box for you as well. But as far as the issue we're having on this car, what we're gonna do next is take the brake pads and the rotors off and take a look at them. And here's a close look at our rotors, and I have to say, at least this rotor on this side looks pretty decent. There's no grooves or any visible damage to the surface of this rotor. And hopefully you guys can see, but there's also plenty of meat on the brake pads on both sides as well. Alright, so I think what happened here is that the last time they did the brake job on this, they probably just replaced the brake pads, and the rotors might have looked good, so they didn't even machine or replace them. So what we're going to do next is to take the brake pads out and take a close look at them, and then also use a micrometer to measure the thickness of the brake rotor and see whether it's warped or not. Now as far as the procedure regarding replacement of disc brake pads and rotors are concerned, I'm going to rush through them in this video, but I'll put a link to a very awesome and detailed video on this side of the screen that I did recently. I'll put a link to that video in the description box below. If you're a beginner and you think of replacing the brake pads and rotors yourself, I definitely recommend you watch that video first. Alright, so first thing I'm going to do is to get a screwdriver in here and push this brake piston in all the way. This is going to make life a lot easier when it's time to put everything back together. Alright, next I'm going to remove these two caliper bolts. Alright, next I'm going to remove this caliper. I'm going to rest it here where it's not dangling off the brake line. Alright, I think I already found the problem. These slide pins, they're not sliding at all. I have to apply a decent amount of force just to turn them, and they're not going back and forth. I probably need some pliers to remove this. This bottom one is a little bit better, but these should be going back and forth without much effort whatsoever, and this bottom one is taking quite a bit of effort just to move back and forth. It's getting better as I'm pushing it back and forth, but it still started off really stiff. And here's a look at our brake pads, and as you can see, these have been replaced recently, and they have plenty of meat on them, and there's no obvious signs of warpage or uneven wear on these pads either. Alright, I'm going to remove this bottom one first and take a closer look. Alright, for starters, there's hardly any grease on this. And what little there is, it is somewhat dry. So, yeah, it just looks like they didn't grease these up properly. Alright, now let's take this top one off. This should do the trick. Nice. And here's a look at the top one. Again, dry. Alright, next I'm going to remove these two caliper bracket bolts. Get this bracket out of here so we can remove our brake rotor. Alright, here's our brake caliper bracket. And here's our brake rotor. Alright, next we're going to check for warpage and measure the thickness of our rotor. In order to do this, you'll need a micrometer like this. It doesn't have to be digital, obviously, but it will help if it is. Next, we'll need to find the minimum allowed thickness for our brake rotor, and this is usually stamped on our brake rotor somewhere, either on the top, on the sides here, maybe around the edges, or more often than not, in the back, inside here, or on the edges themselves. Now, unfortunately, on this rotor, due to the corrosion, I cannot spot the minimum thickness that's supposed to be stamped on this brake rotor, but from the repair manual, I can tell you that it's 22 millimeters minimum allowed thickness for this brake rotor. Next, we're going to take four measurements exactly 90 degrees apart. So we'll start one here, one up top, and one here. All right, so hopefully you guys are going to be able to see this. But our first measurement, we got 22.35. So we'll just go ahead and write that down on a little piece of paper and go on to the next measurement. All right, on this spot, we got 22.4. And for our third measurement, we got 22.4 again. All right, and for our fourth and last measurement, we got 22.42. All right, next, in order to get our run out, we're gonna deduct the largest number we got, which is 22.42 at our last measurement, with the smallest number we got, which is 22.35, and we have 0.07 millimeters of warpage. Now, if this number is not within spec and you need to machine your rotor, you should allow 0.05 millimeters, or in other words, half a millimeter for the machine shop, because that's how much they're gonna take off your rotors usually. That's a rough estimate. And then you should deduct this number, 0.5 millimeters, off the lowest number you measured, which is 22.35, and then compare that to the minimum allowed thickness number you have. And in our case, if we take half a millimeter off of this, this is gonna put it below 22 millimeters. So if this rotor, in our case, needs to be replaced, actually. And here's a look at our shiny new brake rotor. And if you're wondering, the thickness on these rotors, it is stamped on the edges. And I don't know if you guys can see, but it says TH 22 millimeters. And if you're wondering how much you start off with on these, you got 24.24 millimeters. All right, so next I'm gonna replace the rotors and brake pads and all our brake hardware. Then also apply silicone grease to our slide pins and then take you guys on a test drive. All right, so here we are on our test drive and I'm doing about 50 and I'm gonna go ahead and start braking now. No shakes whatsoever. Smooth sailing from here. And that's all there is to it, folks. Again, it's super important to do a brake job properly. And if you are interested in knowing how to do that, again, I'll put a link to that video on this side of the screen. I'll also put some other videos on the screen that might be related to this video. And you can click on those or click on links in the description box down below. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you want to see more like it. And I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.